To solve an equation containing one radical, we want to isolate the radical on one side of the equation, then raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index. This will undo the radical. Then we solve the resulting equation and check our solution or solutions. So for the first example, we have the square root of the quantity 5x minus 1 plus 3 equals 7. So to isolate the square root, we want to undo this plus 3 by subtracting 3 on both sides of the equation. So we'll have the square root of the quantity 5x minus 1 equals 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. And now because we have a square root and the index is 2, we are going to square both sides of the equation. So on the left side, when we square the square root of 5x minus 1, this will simplify to the radicand of 5x minus 1. On the right side, we have 4 squared, which is equal to 16. So now we'll solve this equation by adding 1 to both sides of the equation. So we have 5x equals 17. Divide both sides by 5. And we have our solution, x equals 17/5. Now let's go ahead and check our solution by substituting 17/5 back into the original equation. So we'd have the square root of 5 times 17/5 minus 1 plus 3 equals 7. Well, here these 5 simplify nicely. So we have the square root of 17 minus 1, which would be the square root of 16. Square root of 16 is equal to 4, and 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. So our solution checks. X equals 17/5. Let's take a look at our second example on the next slide. So for our second example, to isolate the square root, we'll have to undo this plus 2 here, as well as this multiplication involving negative 3. So we'll start by subtracting 2 on both sides of the equation. So we'll have negative 3 times the square root of x plus 3. Plus 2 minus 2 is 0, so this equals negative 3 minus 2 is negative 5. And now to isolate the square root, we'll divide both sides by negative 3. So we have the square root of x plus 3 equals, this would be positive 5/3. And now again, because we have a square root and the index is 2, we're going to square both sides of the equation. So when we square the square root of x plus 3, this will simplify to x plus 3, and then 5/3 squared would be 25/9. We square the numerator and square the denominator. And now to solve for x, we'll subtract 3 on both sides of the equation. So we have 25/9 minus 3. Let's take a closer look at that. 25/9 minus 3, or 3 over 1. Well, the common denominator would be 9, so multiply this fraction by 9 over 9. So now we have our common denominator of 9, and the numerator would be 25 minus, this would be 27, so we have negative 2/9. So x equals negative 2/9. And let's go ahead and check this by substituting negative 2/9 into the original equation. So we'd have negative 3 times the square root of negative 2/9 plus 3 plus 2 equals negative 3. Well, negative 2/9 plus 3 is going to be negative 2/9 plus 27/9, which would be 25/9. And the square root of 25/9 would be 5/3. So you have negative 3 times 5/3. Remember, here we're just taking the square root of the numerator and the square root of the denominator separately. So this is the same as negative 3 over 1. This simplifies to 1. So we have negative 5 plus 2, which would be negative 3 equals negative 3. So our solution checks. In the next video, we'll take a look at solving a radical equation when we have an x underneath the square root as well as outside the square root. I hope you found this helpful.